the beautiful Will Rogers Complex in Fort Worth, this is Championship Sports. 2 hours of ringside excitement featuring the world's greatest professional wrestlers. We'll be back with the first match in just a moment.
Spectacular for 1984 is on the air here on Championship Sports. Hello again, everybody. I'm Mark Lawrence here at the magnificent arena of the Tarrant County Convention Center. And we're glad you're with us here on Channel 11 for all of the excitement. Well, we'll be looking for a lot of things tonight. We'll be looking to see what happens with Gary Hart. Now with Chris Adams, they've promised revenge for Jake the Snake Roberts in the television title bout. We'll also be looking for the Lady Giant that Gino Hernandez has supposedly secured. We don't know if anything's going to happen between those parties and Stella May. It may not. We'll just have to wait and see. And, of course, we'll be anxiously awaiting the results of the six-man world title. It's been a long time since we've had a cut-and-dry winner. And hopefully, when this great card is over with, we will have that cut-and-dry winner that we've been looking for. And, of course, it's the American heavyweight title bout. That'll be of great interest. Ric Flair will soon be back with us. And, of course, the holder of the American Heavyweight Championship is always in line for a shot at the world title. So, for Mike Von Erich or Gino Hernandez, depending on who wins, it could be a very important day. Speaking of important things, it's time to introduce Ralph Pulley, who will sing for us tonight as we honor America to get things started on this Labor Day extravaganza.
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. For the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night was still there. Oh, say,
welcome to Championship Sports. And it's the Labor Day Spectacular from the beautiful Tarrant County Convention Center right here in Fort Worth, Texas, where the West begins. All matches this afternoon are sanctioned by the National Wrestling Alliance. The opening event, one fall, 15-minute time limit. Introducing first from Canada, 260 pounds, Kelly Kaninsky. And his very capable opponent from Nashville, Tennessee, 240 pounds, George Weingroff. Rick Hazard, your referee.
All right, here we go. Labor Day Spectacular for 1984. Ralph Pulley with an outstanding job of the Star Spangled Banner. Ralph has performed God Bless America for us here at the Convention Center and at Texas Stadium before, and it was nice to hear the Star Spangled Banner here on Labor Day. Rick Hazard officiating our first bout between Kelly Kaninsky and George Weingroff. One fall, 15-minute time limit. Crowd still coming in. And we're glad that our television crowd is still coming in throughout the great Southwest, and in fact, all over the country now, where Channel 11 is beamed via cable. And down goes Kaninsky quickly. Weingroff scores the first point of our opening event. As everybody gets in, we'll close that door back there in the back, maybe get some of the glare out of your picture. Chris, big twisted around, and Weingroff returns the favor. Tonight, we'll be talking to you folks in Lawton, Oklahoma. Gordman, Lake Worth, Ardmore, Hawkins, and Jacksonville. Boy, every bout in a card like this is a thriller, as every man is giving it 115%. One of the big crowds where the big money's on the line. Weingroff has him down. Now Kaninsky pins his shoulders. Tonight we'll be having our television championship bout, which features Chris Adams challenging Jake the Snake Roberts. Roberts is the man who took him out of that money in a very controversial manner here a few weeks ago. Weingroff hits the near rope, back in the rebound, down goes Kelly. Arm hook, Weingroff will drop kick him away. Over the shoulder and down. We will be talking to General Akbar, Gina Hernandez, Jake the Snake Roberts, Devon Erichs, Chris Adams, Gary Hart, Skip Young, Iceman, King Parsons. Be showing you some arm wrestling action in advance of our 2-3 fall television main event tonight. The right rope. Shoulder butt. Leapfrog. Near rope down, but Weingroff is thrown back as Kaninsky held on to the rope. Kaninsky dies and hits nothing. Over the hip and down, Weingroff in charge for the count of one. As I mentioned on the open, we'll be seeing the results of the six-man world title tonight. Our fans in person will. And General Akbar will be one who is watching with as much intensity as anyone. As you know, that Devastation Incorporated is in line for a six-man world title shot once we get a winner. Left side. Right side, there's a big shoulder and forearm by Kaninsky. Drive to the small of the back. Weingroff with early momentum now is seeing Kaninsky move into the driver's seat. Thank you.
on top. One, two, and that's all. You know, talking about Akbar and an interest in the World Six-Man title, Akbar has done so much with Devastation Incorporated. He's had the big money. He's been able to buy the big talent. But one thing he's not experienced, as we see the neckbreaker, is that world title recognition. He wants that so badly. And when you look at the people he has in his stable, look at Kaminsky with that stomp. The Missing Links, the Killer Khans, the Irwin brothers. You know he can have a six-man team and have one left over just in case. Kaminsky trying to go for a kill here and a first bout victory. There's the knee. And a pin could be, might be, but it isn't. And the bout continues. Here's Joe Rinelli.
5 minutes.
5 minutes gone in our opening bout. Heron County Convention Center, downtown Fort Worth. Hard to tell what the crowd's going to be because it's early yet. Weingraub back to his feet. Wants to pull Kelly Kaminsky off the top of him. Elbow to the midsection. Left side rope. Near side. But a kick in the midsection stops Weingraub's attempt. Glenn Goes is with us tonight. Be chatting with him, hearing him sing shortly. And, of course, our television main event is going to be that six-man event between Hacksaw Butch Reed and the Pretty Young Things against Terry Skip and the Iceman. Both men go down. Weingraub hits the hardest. Kaminsky back up quickly. And Kaminsky draws the ire of the crowd. Graph on the seat of his pants. There's a drive across the chest. Boy, talking about Akbar in that six-man situation, the other night the sportatorium really got out of hand when, thanks to Akbar's hard work, it was 2-on-1. They ganged up on Terry, the Missing Link and Killer Khan. One, two, and a foot over the rope saves George Weingraub. That forced a tag team bout later on, and it was really wild. As Akbar will focus his attention on those six-man teams currently in existence, the Freebirds and, of course, Devon Erichs. And then, of course, the winner of tonight's bout will be receiving all of his attention. With the tights, he takes him down, and you can see that. Kaminsky is claiming no harm done, no wrong, but the fans know otherwise. We will not have a tape feature for you tonight, since this is such a feature card in itself. We'll show you as much of this as we can all through the evening. That American Heavyweight Championship bout for you. Several tag team bouts, two to be specific. Kaminsky goes down, Weingraub. Gets a cheer from the crowd. Keep in mind, this man has the sight problem, legally blind, can see images and light only. Head on the turnbuckle. Kaminsky, the big Canadian, showing him no mercy. Works over the back of the neck. Slams that head on the turnbuckle again. Count of just one, and that's it. Following the Glenn Goes apiece, we'll have our television championship bout, and Gary Hart, now the advisor for gentleman Chris Adams. And you heard the harsh words he had for Jake the Snake Roberts on our show last week. And tonight's when payoff time will occur. The
Red card coming to Lawton, Oklahoma. Will be running down. Be good to be back in Lawton. I enjoyed being up there for the last one. Gino Hernandez has issued a personal invitation to Stella May to show up in Lawton. Says, I have a surprise for you, Stella. This way! There's that kick. Konitsky thought he was going to throw him over. And Weingraf surprised him with a kick to the upper body. Here's a pin. One. And that's all.
Bob Whiteside, ringside, please. Bob Whiteside to the ringside table.
To the corner. Konitsky underneath his Weingraf. Surprised him. Takes him over the leg. Oh, oh, we thought he had him. Nice move by Weingraf, sitting on top of that turnbuckle. There's the clothesline.
Ten minutes.
There's a dive by Kelly Konitsky. Weingraf out of the way. Got his pin. Two, three. It's all over.
And the winner in 10 minutes. In 10 minutes and 47 seconds, George Weingraf.
Weingraf with an exciting victory. So Weingraf with an exciting victory here to open our show. We'll be back for Glenn Goza in just a moment.
Count to see in Fort Worth, 8 o'clock. Be on hand to see Killer Khan and the Missing Link with Devastation Incorporated. Team against Kevin and Kerry Von Erich. Gino Hernandez will be facing Iceman King Parson. You'll be seeing George Weingraf face Wild Bill Irwin. Other great names in the card include Jake the Snake Roberts. We'll have a newcomer in by the name of Ricky Torres. Coco Ware will face gentleman Chris Adams in an exciting bout. So you'll want to be on hand for all of the excitement Monday night. Will Rogers Coliseum at 8 o'clock. Now then, for you folks at home on television, I'm going to visit with Glenn Goza for the second time this evening. With the first time, we had all kinds of problems. So, Glenn, let's talk a little bit about your wrestling background.
All right. We were discussing earlier. Our background goes back to the days in Houston when Fritz Von Erich himself was one of the top contenders for national championships, big heavyweight wrestler in the Houston area in my early memories. And we've been a wrestling fan ever since. As a matter of fact, I've even worked your side of the matches sometimes, being a ring announcer.
Now, of course, you were the man who wrote Heaven Needed a Champion in honor of David Von Erich. And that is just, of course, the tip of the iceberg for your music career, is you'll be starting an old tradition back in Dallas.
That's true. The music fans, as well as the wrestling fans, will remember the not too many early days ago when the world-famous Sportatorium in Dallas was home of the Big D Jamboree. We're reviving that show as of October 13th under the name of the Big D Jamborama. And we're going to have a lot of top music talent on hand, and it'll be an every other night Saturday affair to begin with, and we're looking for everybody to come and join us.
Okay, I know everyone will look forward to that. A lot of stars have been born in the Dallas area with shows like this. Without further ado, I'm going to turn it over to you and let you have it. You can say what you need to and then get on with the music.
Thank you very much. A new version of the song called Wrestling, which we did for you on July 4th, I believe it was, at this very site, under these very same conditions, as I remember. Here's the new version. It's called Wrestling. Well, my girlfriend called. Let's go to wrestling. R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. My boss called again, said, friend, we could be model for Fredericks of Hollywood, but it's kind of nasty. We were wrestling. R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. Well, my boss called again, said, come on in, 7:30. I had to laugh, I'm going to wrestling. Going to wrestling. R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. Well, my girlfriend called. Friends, she could be a model for Fredericks of Hollywood, but she was hassling. Really hassling. Said I could come over early and stay real late, but I told her, honey, if we have a date, we're going to wrestling. Going to wrestling. R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. I love to watch the missing link bang his head on a corner post and the rumper bumper butt-butt delivered by the Iceman. Roberts, Hayes, and Gordy. But what I like the most is Kerry delivering the iron claws on Lita Von Erich's can. Well, my girlfriend called. I said, I hope you ain't hurt. She said, I'm putting on my wrestling shirt. I'm going to wrestling. Going to wrestling. R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. Well, last night I dreamed my life was over. There were golden streets and fields of clover, and the lights, they were dazzling. I looked for old St. Peter at the pearly gate. I found a note that said, I won't be too late. I'm going to wrestling. Going to wrestling. R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. Gentleman Chris Adams with his super kick in place. Young Mike Von Erich with his own iron claw. I'll never forget the classic battles of the 70s and 80s. Two champions, Harley Race and David Von Erich. St. Peter told me if he let me in, from now on every Monday and Friday, Glenn, we're going to wrestling. Going to wrestling. R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. Boy, if I'd known this was going to happen, I wouldn't have bought these advance tickets. Tell me, St. Pete, will these wings fit in a ringside seat? Is old Fritz coming up here anytime soon? R-A-S-S-L-I-N, that's wrestling. Thank you.
We'll be back for more Championship Sports as Gary Hart will be out with Chris Adams. Stay with us. Great Plains Coliseum in Lawton, Oklahoma, Wednesday night, the 12th of September. At the Great Plains Coliseum, you'll be seeing stars such as Mike and Kevin Von Erich, Iceman King Parsons, Skip Young, Gina Hernandez, The Missing Link, The Pretty Young Things, Gentleman Chris Adams, Rock and Roll Zoom Off, and many, many others. And as I mentioned, Gina Hernandez has issued a very special invitation to Stella May. He says he has a surprise. That's Lawton, Oklahoma, Wednesday, September 12th at the Great Plains Coliseum. Well, you see Gary Hart, Chris Adams, Jake the Snake Roberts, and Bronco Lubitsch all here in the ring. We'll look forward to see the outcome of this bout. Let's get it started with Joe Ranella.
This is to beat the television champion, the purse tonight, $1,500. One fall, 15-minute time limit. Introducing first from England, 235 pounds, and the former television champion, gentleman Chris Adams. And with him, his advisor, the incomparable Gary Hart. From Louisiana, 240 pounds, the television champion, Jake the Snake Roberts. Bronco Lubitsch, your referee.
Television title, Bronco Lubitsch with the belt, Jake the Snake Roberts tightening up his britches, Gary Hart dressed up, the advisor of gentleman Chris Adams. And remember, it was Jake the Snake that took
$5,000 right out of the hand of Chris Adams when the big bout took place 3 or 4 weeks ago. And Jake the Snake Roberts doesn't seem the least bit concerned right now with Chris Adams or Gary Hart. Jake the Snake, a sort of a society child, blames society for all of the things that he loves to do, blaming you and me for creating him that way. The bell has sounded. Here we go. One fall, 15-minute time limit. One of two title events you'll be seeing in the show tonight. Adams hits hard. Jake the Snake backed into the corner. A fine headlock by Chris Adams as Gary Hart has stationed himself to our right. And as Gary Hart always does, looking on very, very emphatically. Adams locking up that head of Jake the Snake Roberts. Roberts trying to force him over to get the shoulders down. Count of two, and that's it. The Snake tried to force his way back to his feet. He's on one knee. $1,500 on the line. They're in the ropes with a handful of tight sticks. The Snake throws it, but Adams turns the tables and hooks Jake the Snake over. And now the big tall, lanky man from Louisiana is in the corner. Jake the Snake urging Adams to keep his distance. Great card Monday night. It will Rogers Coliseum, Devastation Incorporated versus Yvonne Erics as Adams does some cartwheels and again has Roberts in the corner. But keep in mind, Jake the Snake can come out of nowhere and surprise everyone. The bout isn't over till you get the 1-2-3 with Jake the Snake Roberts. Locks up that wrist in that half Nelson hold. Making noise for gentleman Chris Adams. They'd like to see him return to the throne of television champion. Jake the Snake now puts the foot over the back of the knee and clips it down to the ring.
Can't do that if you've got a wife, then.
Now Adams will clip that knee and force Jake the Snake down. Jake the Snake Roberts, better than 6 feet 3 inches tall. Speaking of tall people, this lady giant that Gino has got is 6'2". A great big girl. And I can tell by looking at her, I saw her in the back, that she can handle herself. Adams barring the arm. Keep in mind, the television title always has the 15-minute time limit. Gary Hart has stayed in almost one place so far. watching very intently. He does not have another manager to keep his eye on. His attention solely on the ballot. We're 5 minutes deep. Adams over the rope. Jake the Snake with a slap across the chest. There's the knee lift. And we heard that one pop as that knee hit the face. Points to Gary Hart and lets Adams have it under the arm. Now straddles the body as he bars that arm, and this bout is beginning to pick up. There's one of the signs in the crowd out of glittering of the glittering variety. Adams to his feet with a hair. Roberts pulls him down, and Adams is getting angry. And look at Jake the Snake, look at Gary Hart and smile, and he had better be careful. There's Gary Hart, he's getting a little closer now. Hammer locks that arm. Gary Hart minding his P's and Q's on the surface, but the wheels are turning in that brain of his, I know. Roberts goes down after Adams spun and caught him with the elbow to the side of the head, but he gets the foot over the rope. Bronco Lubitsch checking that arm. Jake the Snake Roberts still there. Finally gets himself out under that rope, which causes Bronco Lubitsch to count him off and Adams to break the hold. Jake the Snake out on the floor. He's a little bit dazed. And Jake the Snake ducks under just enough to get the count started over again and then dives back out on the floor. Now, he'll come back to the apron, but I'm not sure he's going to get back in the ring. He is via the top turnbuckle. Oh, I'm not sure Jake the Snake's all there. Adams is there, though. Throws him across. And Jake the Snake Roberts. I don't know if this is an act or if he's really out of it. We'll have to wait and see. He may be trying to surprise or fool Adams. There's a body slam, and Jake the Snake crawls out before Adams hits on the return. Both men slow to come back. Gary Hart with one knee on the apron. Jake the Snake sliding over, fooling with his drawstring, something in his hand from the tight.
He's concealing it under there. He got Adams across the throat. He's got it in his hand. Tosses it away. And into the crowd. Now Adams has something in his hand. Did that come from Gary or what? But now Roberts pays and pays dearly. One. And that's all.
5 remaining.
5 minutes remaining. Check for St. Roberts begging for mercy. First, Roberts pulled out the foreign object, and then Chris Adams did the same. Over the top rope goes Adams. But Adams made the mistake of shoving the referee away where he couldn't see it. And it's really getting spicy now. Gary Hart around on that side. And I'm not sure where that piece of tape or screen came from that Adams had. It may have come from Gary Hart. Gary helps Adams back in the ring, but there's that double-handed chop across the throat by Jake the Snake Roberts. Jake the Snake picks him up, drops him hard on the top of the back and shoulders. One, two, and a foot over the rope stops the count. Now you know that Gary Hart didn't do that. Jake the Snake Roberts knows otherwise. Gary Hart dragged the cheers from the crowd. There's the drive to the side of the head.
There's only 3 minutes remaining.
Three minutes remaining. Jake the Snake Roberts now on his feet. The ebb and flow of this bout has seen first one man, then the other. The rules have been toyed with. There's a clothesline. Jake the Snake on top. He thinks he's got him. Gary Hart distracted him beautifully. Gary Hart stuck under the rope just to get Jake the Snake off. Now Gary removes his coat. Distracting Bronco Lubbock. Jake the Snake throws Adams over the rope again, but here he is back. Three.
Television champion, gentlemen, Chris Adams.
Let's quickly recap. Jake the Snake on top for the three count. Gary Hart stuck under the rope like he was coming after him, and Jake the Snake went after him. Adams then got up, but when Bronco Livingston went over to Gary Hart, Jake the Snake went and threw Adams over the top rope for the second time during the bout. What an exciting victory. Chris Adams again, the television champion. We'll be back for more. Don't go.
It'll be held in the Lake Worth High School gym in Lake Worth, Texas on Saturday night, September the 15th. The bouts will start at 8 o'clock. The ring sponsored by the Lake Worth Band patrons. On that card, Kevin Von Erich, Chris Adams, Gino Hernandez, The Missing Link, George Weingraub, Skip Young, Scott Arwin, and the Pretty Young Things. That's Lake Worth Saturday, September 15th in the high school gym at 8 o'clock. Now it's my pleasure to have the Von Erichs with me. Kevin, Kerry, Mike, all kinds of things happening between you all and Devastation Incorporated, and you're going to be in the corner and you're going to be involved two different nights this week.
Well, Kerry's going to be wrestling Killer Khan coming up Friday, and I'm not on the card wrestling, but knowing Akbar and his reputation, I'm going to be right there in Kerry's corner to make sure he doesn't do anything. That's Kerry against Khan Friday night.
All right, Kerry. A big bout. Akbar has his eyes on you and the Freebirds. He wants a six-man shot.
That's right, he sure does, but I want to mention right now Friday night. You know, everybody knows what happened last Friday when Missing Link hit the ring, probably from Akbar's orders. Well, I've asked my brother Kevin to be in my corner Friday night to keep all interference out of the ring, so it'll be just me and Killer Khan. Yeah. Then, also, get this. Also coming up Monday night, we've got a tag team match. Killer Khan and Missing Link against me and Kerry. How about that?
And, of course, another opportunity for revenge, Kerry.
That's right, Mark. You know, I tell you, Kevin and I, we're going against probably number one and two top animals in all of professional wrestling. Well, brother Kevin and I now are more ready than we've ever been. We're working more as a unit, more as a team. And I guess the reason we're doing so well right now is because we've been training so hard to win this six-man world title tonight. So we are ready. Hey. Let me say this, too. Folks, you can feel the air here. It's magic. It's electricity, folks. We're going to win that title tonight.
All right. Best of luck to you in that quest for the six-man world title. Gary Hart and Chris Adams. And, guys, the fans have loved what they've seen so far.
I think Chris has something he would like to say all the people before I have to say what I think everyone wants to hear.
All right, Chris, television champion again.
Thank you, Mark. Well, as I told you people a couple of weeks ago, that I trust Gary Hart to be my advisor and manager, and it looks like it's already started to pay off. And just to use facts as an example, Jake the Snake Roberts tried everything he could in this match right now to stop me winning this belt. For example, he threw me over the ropes twice. But the first time, Gary Hart, my advisor, told me, this belt cannot be won on a disqualification. Get in there and beat him. And I did, as you see.
Gary?
As I said last week, this is only the beginning of Christopher Adams and Gary Hart, and we have a common goal. Tonight, our goal was to win back the TV title, which I think Chris Adams did in grand style. Number two is the 8 pounds of gold that's around you, Ric Flair. And in the very near future, just like Chris Adams took the TV title off of you, Jake the Snake Roberts, Ricky Flair, you like to talk about how bad you are. Well, the nastiest and evilest and smartest dude in Texas all was Gary Hart, and I'm gonna put everything I know in his brain, and he gonna be the one that takes the gold off of you in the near future, Ricky Flair. One other thing I would like to say about Skandar Akaba. I hope you were watching Chris Adams tonight, Akaba, because he's gonna go through devastation in Carper just like salt through a goose, brother. So come and get Chris Adams and Gary Hart.
All right. The fans love what they see so far, Chris Adams and Gary Hart. Here's one of the most exciting duos we have going now, Skip Young and Iceman and King Parsons. And, of course, it's going to be team action this week, and also another big bout involving you. Skip, Ice, we'll start with you.
Yeah, that's right, brother. But let me say this. Half-breed. That's right. I'm talking about you, Gino Hernandez. You slicked me once, sucker. But now you got to do it again. So Monday night, bring it all, because we're going to do it. Monday, it's me and you, sucker. Can you dig it? Mercy.
All right. Skip, of course, it's the Irwins coming up this week, too.
Next Friday night, me and Iceman King Parsons is going to take Wild Bill Irwin and Hog Scott Irwin and send them straight back to the pasture with them whips where they belong. And if they bring them whips down there Friday night at that sportatorium and whip me an Iceman, they gonna have to leave here on the first train south.
All right, anything else, Ice?
I don't think I need to say anymore, because my partner said it all. Can you dig it, Wild Bill? Have mercy!
Okay, an exciting team, Iceman King Parsons and Skip Young. When we come back, it's our television main event, preceded by the exciting arm wrestling bout between Kerry Von Erich and Axel Batree. We'll be right back. Stay here. Let me remind you about the action here in Fort Worth as we're back at Will Rogers Coliseum Monday night at 8 o'clock. Wild Bill Irwin faces George Weingraf. Coco Ware, that's one of the pretty young things, will be facing gentleman Chris Adams. That bout will be for the television title. Jake the Snake Roberts will now be facing Ricky Torres, a new name. Gino Hernandez will be in one of two main events against Iceman King Parsons. Killer Khan and the Missing Link go against Kevin and Kerry Von Erich. Monday night, Will Rogers Coliseum at 8 o'clock. David Manning has arrived here in the ring. I'm going to turn things over to Ralph Pulley for the entrance of our six men to come to the ring and the explanation about the arm wrestling.
All right, this is the television main event. Best two out of three falls, 30-minute time limit. It's a six-man tag team match. But before the match begins, we're going to have a test of arm strength featuring Hacksaw Butch Reed and Kerry Von Erich. Teamed with Hacksaw Butch Reed will be, of course, the Pretty Young Things, Norvell Austin, Coco Ware, and the other tag team will consist of Iceman King Parsons, Skip Young, and Kerry Von Erich.
Remember, we'll have arm wrestling in advance of this. Mr. T type tone of voice, ready to face Kerry Von Erich. Now, both of these guys have tremendous builds, tremendous physiques. And this is all put together to show who has the strongest of the upper body. The table is there, the men will be on their feet. Now, Jim, do we need to get the table turned the other way? Okay. Kerry's ready. Here's David Manning.
All right, listen up. Both elbows have to stay on the table. When one, the back of one person's hand touches the table, the other man's the winner. It's that simple. All right, let's put them down.
Got the camera too. Okay, here we go. Now, we should have an excellent view of this because Jim Lund has got our floor cameras positioned on either side of the table. as the fans are already chanting for Kerry Von Erich. Boy, did you see that muscle. Here we go. David Manning will be right there keeping the elbows on the table. And of course, there's some cheerleaders in the ring, the teammates that will be involved in this six-man event. Hacksaw Reed. He is never quiet. Well, you've seen many of these battles go on over the bar and all kinds of establishments. High school arm wrestling contest. Always a test of the strength between men. Listen to this crowd. Hacksaw Reed slowly giving way. Hey, what is this? Oh, we were looking forward to seeing this, and the pretty young thing jumped in the middle of it all. What's going to happen now? All six men involved, and that big table still in there. There's the head on the table. Hacksaw Reed, boy, I must have had that all worked out. Hey, guys, if I begin to fade, you know what to do. And all of one side is out on the floor. Norvell, Austin, Coco Ware, and Hacksaw Reed. Hacksaw Reed being helped to his feet. And I guess now they'll move the table out and get the first fall started. Remember, this is the TV main event. Hacksaw Reed is bleeding. Boy, when he hit that table, that opened up that forehead. Now, you've got to consider Kerry the winner of that, even though the arm never got fully down. I think Kerry wants to start again. Hacksaw Reed being helped out. Hacksaw Reed is being helped to the back. And he may not be able to continue here. Now what's going to happen? We have the pretty young things out on the floor bargaining with David Manning. Ice Man, Skip Young, and Kerry. Here's David. David is going to tell us.
All right, the pretty young things say that Butch Reed is unable to wrestle, so David Manning says it's going to have to be 3-on-2.
Okay, the pretty young things will not like that decision, but after what they did, you can certainly understand. It will now be 3-on-2. They've gotten the table out of the ring. Well, let's get it started. Here's Kerry wanting the mic now.
You know,
hey, what's that set up?
I came to this ring and I did what I had to do. So now I'm leaving it up to Skip Young and Iceman to take care of the pretty young thing.
Kerry's going to make it even and get ready for the sixth man. Now we're back to 2-on-2. There's the pair of high fives. And here we go. The pretty young thing against the Iceman, King Parsons, and Skip Young, known as Sweet Brown Sugar. 2 of 3 falls. Here we go with fall number one.
Don't forget, this is 2 out of 3 falls.
two Negroes, we're going to beat them, baby. We're going to beat these two Negroes.
Referee stance between these two comes to the near rope. There's a drive by Norvell Austin to the Iceman right back. Referee stands center of the ring. Iceman locks him up with the side of the head. Over near Coco Ware. Ware is wearing the tights with the writing down the side. Iceman disposes of him and moves.
Come on, baby, come on.
Norvell Austin back to the center.
Come on now. Come on. Come on.
Coco Ware reaching across. He wants the tag. Iceman kicks that hand away. Here it comes through. Iceman saw it coming and throws him over. Leg scissors. Iceman has them both. Iceman wants to turn him over and does. Drop kick just caught him on the side of the shoulder. Drop kicks wear away. And Iceman and Skip Young are in the ring. The Pretty Young Things are outside. First fall action. High fives again. Norvell Austin, Iceman King Parsons, the two legal men in the ring.
Oh, shut up, I'm kidding, baby.
Side headlock to the Iceman moves over. Here's the tag, and Skip Young will move in. Skip Young surprising Norvell Austin, and the Pretty Young Things have had little go their way in the first few minutes of this bout. Near side ropes on the rebound. He comes back to the leapfrog. Second time. There's the kick. Here's Ware drop kicked away. Skip Young is everywhere, and the Pretty Young Things are outside the ring again. You know, you can't help but do a lot of wondering and a lot of thinking about what is happening between Gary Hart and Chris Adams. Now, Gary's had the fans fired up, and he had Chris Adams fired up, and of course, Chris is a emerging superstar on his own, and with Gary Hart now, it's going to be interesting to see what happens, but like I say, you can't help but do a lot of wondering. Locked up again, Skip Young and Norvell Austin. They move to the turnbuckle. Skip Young climbs high, Zumhoff style. There's the count of two. Coco Ware getting on to some of the fans. That gets the crowd stirred up. Here's the tag. Iceman back in legally. Immediately locks up Norvell Austin right where Skip Young left off. American Heavyweight Championship coming up for you. Will we see this lady giant? I don't know. It all depends on whether or not we see Stella May, I guess. We'll just have to wait and see. To the back. Oh, Iceman went down. There's the leapfrog turning, takes him down. Looks like he wanted to drop kick, but when he saw he was going to kick him too soon, he grabbed him with that foot and caused him to lose his balance. But Austin still got the momentum anyway, and here's Ware on the tag. misses the knee. Iceman turns over. He's down. Austin back in. Pretty Young Things tagging in and out with regularity. There's a headbutt by Norvell. Austin isn't going to go anywhere with that. We've seen that before with the Iceman, that head of steel. There's the drive to the side of the head. Now Ware comes in. That opens the door for Austin, who's got a pin. Count of two. Both men are down now. David Manning counting. Which man will come back first? Iceman is on his feet. He wants to come to the corner. Tag Skip Young. Here's the refreshed man in. Over and down. There's the drive in the midsection, and David Manning ducks out of the way. There's a kick to the side of the head. Headlock. Left rope. Shoulder butt down. Turns him over and slams him. Nice move by Ware. Ware says, take care of this puck as Norvell Austin climbs the rope. Comes down with a splashing clothesline. Two, three, and fall number one is history. The Pretty Young Things go up one fall to none.
Winners of the first fall in 6 minutes and 49 seconds, Norvell Austin and Coco Ware.
We will be back. Stay with us. Team action that we mentioned on the interview. Iceman King Parsons and Skip Young going against the magnificent Irwin brothers. Jake the Snake Roberts faces Buck Rock and Roll Zumhoff. Norvell Austin goes against George Weingraub. Friday night, the Dallas Ford Auditorium at 8 o'clock. It's Conn versus Kerry with Kevin in the corner and much more. We'll see you then. Now back to the ring. Okay, the Pretty Young Things are up one fall to none. As Skip Young and the Iceman talk over three fall strategy. Let's ring the bell and go. David Manning having a word with the Iceman. There's the bell. Second fall is underway. Skip Young will open it up with Norvell Austin. Excitement coming to Ardmore. The greatest card ever to Ardmore, I'm sure. On hand at the Coliseum. We'll be talking about that later on. To the corner goes Skip Young. There's the drive. Skip Young, that hurt him. Young hanging tough. Coco Ware with a blow to the top of the head. Another drive to the face. Norvell Austin was laughing with Skip Young the other day. He says, I just don't know how these two could call themselves pretty. Bad training for Skip Young as Coco Ware comes in and drops the back of the knee over the chin. Coco Ware off that turnbuckle. Here's the pin. Is it all over? No. Pretty Young Things showing signs of winning in two straight. Skip Young in bad shape right now. Boy, if he could get over for a tag, should he get out from this pin? Now Ware grabbed the tights to help hold him down, but Skip Young kicked out anyway. Crowd making a lot of noise, and they'll be making more as this card progresses. Both men to their feet, and there's a blow to the midsection. Up in the air, he's got him, wants to slam him, and does so. You folks in Fort Hood, Burleson, and Valley View, be with us next week. We'll be talking about excitement coming your way. Of course, Burleson is Tim Russell country. Good, good way, come off the top turnbuckle, and Skip Young knew it. And let him have it. Here's the dual count. Crowd roaring. Here comes Austin in, but just as Austin hits, Skip Young gets the tag. Here's the Iceman refreshed and ready. Listen to the crowd go ooh with every blow. Headbutt, here's the pin, one, two, and that's all. Over and down on the shoulder. Here's Iceman out, Skip Young comes in with a diving drop kick. What a move, two, three, and there's nothing to take away anybody else could do about it. We're all even.
Winner of the second fall in 4 minutes and 15 seconds, Skip Young and Iceman King Parsons.
So we're all even, and the third fall will be the deciding fall. From the Tarrant County Convention Center downtown Fort Worth, you're watching Championship Sports. Ardmore tomorrow, the action begins at 7 o'clock at the Ardmore Coliseum. You fans will be seeing five great bouts. The most exciting card ever to come to Ardmore. All of your favorite stars will be on hand, and you'll want to be there along with them. That's Ardmore, Oklahoma, at the Ardmore Coliseum tomorrow night, Sunday night at 7 p.m. Now back to the ring, our third and deciding call. Ring the bell, here we go. We're all even. This is the decider. Norvell Austin looks a little weary as the third fall begins, and he shows it now as Skip Young picks up right where he left off. What a sensational dive he had, feet first from that top rope. Here's the Iceman, and Hacksaw Reed unable to go in this bout after the arm wrestling melee, which caused his head to be driven into the table. Here's Skip Young in, and look at these guys going back and forth. Terry Von Erich then did not go as he left the ring to leave it two on two. So what started out as a six-man bout is now a regular tag team event. And the Iceman and Skip Young have Norvell Austin in a daze. One, two. Skip Young from behind. That sleeper with Austin already kind of weary, probably a good move for Young to be using. Big action this week in Fort Worth and Dallas. Hope you're on hand in both buildings as we see Skip Young now. Iceman, boy, first one man, then the other. Here's another tag so quickly. Some of the fans chanting along one, two, three with each of those blocks. Iceman. There's a headbutt. Boy, that floors him. One, two. Here's a small package. Could be. Might be. No, it isn't. Look out. Here's Hacksaw Reed out of nowhere. Hacksaw Butch Reed comes in.
A melee has broken loose. I'm gonna read slamming Skip Young, the Pretty Young Things are on the ice there. Oh boy, here comes Terry back out. We're back to six men again. Hacksaw Reed dives out. And I'm sure, yes, they will get the call in the match.
All right, David Manning, because of outside interference, David Manning declares Skip Young and Iceman King Parsons the winner.
What a wild and surprising ending to the third fall as Hacksaw Reed with his head bandage came from the back. And it's a good thing Kerry was watching the monitor because he was right on top of the action as soon as Reed arrived. When we come back, we'll be talking to some more people and then have the American Heavyweight Championship bout. As you see, the winners will stay right here.
We've got two exciting cards coming up. Be on hand in Hawkins, Texas, in East Texas, for the bouts to be held on Tuesday, September the 11th. The matches will start at 7:30 in the evening and are being sponsored by the Hawkins Youth Baseball Association. Appearing on the card, Kevin Monterey, Chris Adams, Buck Rock and Roll Zumoff, Killer Khan, Wild Bill Irwin, Skip Young, Scott Hall Gerwin, and the Pretty Young Things. That's Hawkins, Tuesday, September the 11th in the high school gym at 7:30. Another big date is Thursday, September 13th, as main event wrestling matches will be held on the 13th in the Gorman High School Football Stadium. The matches will start at 8 o'clock and are being sponsored by the Gorman Band Boosters. Appearing on the card, Kerry Von Erich, Iceman King Parsons, Chief Jules Strongbow, Gino Hernandez, The Missing Link, George Weingraf, Scott Hall Gerwin, and Pretty Young Thing Coco Ware. That's Gorman, Thursday, September 13th at the football field, 8 o'clock. Here's General Akbar.
As everybody knows, that the general makes the biggest deals in all of professional wrestling. For example, my latest effort in acquiring Killer Khan from the Freebirds. But there's one thing that has eluded the general, and that's that six-man world crown. And I'll be watching with interest later on this evening, because I want the winner, and I indeed will compromise a team to get and lift that world crown and put it in the general stable. Also, I understand the world's heavyweight champion, Ric Flair, is on his way. Well, I know Ric Flair can't beat the Missing Link. I know Ric Flair can't beat Killer Khan. And I know that that world championship is going to be in the general stable house, right where it belongs. Now, come next Monday night, it's Kevin and Kerry against the Missing Link and Killer Khan. And you know what that is, boy? That's double disaster. So if you can find your way back here to Fort Worth, you do so, Kevin, and you, Kerry. And Friday, of all things, it's Kerry and Killer Khan. And Kevin, you have no seconds license. You have no business in that corner in that match. And I'm going to appeal to the NWA about this ridiculous stipulation of Kevin being in the corner. And one more thing, the Long Riders, yeah, the Irwin brothers. That Skip Young, anybody that calls himself sweet has to have something wrong with him. And you, Iceman, yeah, you're going down too on Friday. All right, disaster. It's Devastation Incorporated, and we're going to get it all.
General Akbar, upset about Kevin Monterey being the punter. Gino Hernandez wants it quiet here in the arena, and you can hear the silence right now. Gino, you've got the Indian this week and more.
The day of reckoning has come. I don't see no Stella Mae showing her face out here tonight, and I will never have to have a case of paranoia again. I'm talking about Monday night. Iceman King Parsons, you've never won anything in your life except maybe a Mr. T look-alike contest. You're nothing. When I get through with you, you can set up a little shoe shine hut somewhere in the airport or somewhere. As far as that washed-up Indian, you can go back to the reservation and work in your teepee or weaving blankets or something. But I would like to say, I know that Ric Flair is coming very soon, and after tonight, I will get my belt back. So
there's that silence again.
I will have my belt back, and yes, once again, I will be your champion. Because there is no more worries. My bodyguard is here. And Stella Mae, you don't have enough guts to show up. Mike Von Erich, I'm going to beat you like a redheaded stepchild tonight and get my belt back.
Gino Hernandez is ready for that American belt, and he thinks he's gotten rid of Stella Mae with the threat of this lady giant. Here's Jake the Snake Roberts.
First things first, I have not come out here to testify about my bad misfortunes. Because I tell you something, I really don't care about what has happened. The future is the only thing I look forward to. Let's straighten one thing out right now. I'm a little bit different than everybody else. In that way, I'm going to tell you how I'm different. You know, ever since the beginning of time, you people that are sitting out here in this large arena, ever since birth, when the day you were born, you looked up at your mother and your father and you said, Daddy, can I be a doctor? And your daddy said, yes, son, you can be a doctor. You can be anything you want as long as you try hard. You said, Daddy, but can I be a lawyer if I want to be a lawyer? Your father looked you square in the eye, didn't he, Mark? And he said, yes, you can be a lawyer. You can be anything you want to be as long as you will take the time to work for it. Well, I tell you one thing right here. You can be just about anything in the world you want to be, except for one. There is only one thing you cannot be, Mark Lorenz. Do you know what that is?
No, I have an idea. I'm going to find out, though.
That is the very best there is in this ring. That's because I am. If you will take time. Oh, hey, come on. I've been out here being Mr. Nice Guy. You had Gary Hart out here at ringside. I don't care. Let Gary Hart come out here. Let Mrs. Hart come out here. And let him bring his sniveling kids out here. I don't care. Because I tell you one thing. I stepped into Dallas and Fort Worth being so nice and so cool and so laid back. And the first time I stepped into Fort Worth, I beat you, Chris Adams. Well, starting from now on, I'm going to make examples, Mark Lorenz. I'm going to make an example of every man that steps into the ring with me. If you don't believe the DDT is the worst thing that can happen to you, then step right up right now and put one right here, because I really don't care. So why don't you come on up? I'm asking anybody, Kerry Von Erich, David, all of them, bring them on up, because it doesn't mean anything to me to drop somebody on their face, even you, Mark.
Well, I hope you don't do that. Jake the Snake Roberts, ready to get nasty after what he called a very pleasant beginning. Obviously upset about the television title that took place earlier tonight. We'll be back for more in just a moment. To our exciting American Heavyweight Championship bout, let's talk about the card coming to Jacksonville as Main Event Wrestling be held in the Jacksonville Rodeo Arena in Jacksonville, Texas on Saturday night, September 15th. The action begins at 8 o'clock, and the action is being sponsored by the Cherokee Foster Parent Association. On this exciting card, you will be seeing Kerry Von Erich, Iceman King Parsons, Killer Khan, Buck Rock and Roll Zumhoff, Chief Jules Strongbow, Jake the Snake Roberts, Wild Bill Irwin, and Pretty Young Thing Norvell Austin. That's Jacksonville, Saturday, September the 15th in the Rodeo Arena at 8 o'clock. It's time for our next bout to get started. Bronco Lubitsch is in the ring. If I can find the ring announcer, Joe Rinelli, I'll give him the mic.
This is for the American heavyweight title. One fall, 60-minute time limit. In the ring at this time, from Highland Park, 240 pounds, the fashion plate of wrestling, and the challenger, Gino Hernandez. An 226 pounds, the American heavyweight champion, Mike Van Erich. Michael Lubick, your referee.
Okay, the bout that many of these fans have been waiting for the American Heavyweight Championship. Gino Hernandez, who once owned this belt, along with the Texas title, lost this belt to Mike Van Erich. And that was back in the beginning of the problems he has had with Stella May. And you hear the fans chanting for Stella May now. For it was that night at the Sportatorium that Gino was distracted by a blonde woman with a similar hairdo to Stella May at ringside. That enabled Mike to get a break and win the bout. Well, that didn't turn out to be Stella May, it was someone else, and Gino was embarrassed by it all. So Mike is defending the belt tonight. I don't see Stella May anywhere or this lady giant. It must be a Mexican standoff. And it looks like we're going to have a clean bout, the kind we've been hoping for. To the corner goes Mike Van Erich. Gino crashes and hits nothing but ring post. The action is fast-paced. Chops Mike across the chin, holding the arm all the time. Now here's Mike grabbing Gino on the near rope. Takes him over with a toss. Down with the elbow. Gino down to the count of just two. Far too early to see a pinfall in this type of bout, I would guess anyway. Now, we haven't seen much of Mike in the previous weeks. He's been working hard. This is an important bout, as we mentioned. Ric Flair moving in the coming weeks for a world title defense. Flair has already said that Kerry's not getting another shot. Not going to take another chance of losing to the man who's beaten me once. So you would think that American heavyweight man is the next man in line. It will be either Gino or Mike Van Erich.
Oh, no.
And we know that Mike has always had an advantage with Flair. You know, sometimes a particular team in sports will own an advantage over another, like the Baltimore Orioles and California Angels over the years. Ever since the Angels moved to the LA area, the Orioles have had their number. And Mike Van Erich has started out that way with Ric Flair, if you'll think back to that 10-minute bout here at the convention center a year ago, Labor Day. Elbow by Hernandez. On the ropes. Flip. Leg scissors stop that. Head on the turnbuckle. And again, I point out no sign of the lady. What a suplex. Here's Gino climbing high. Backwards diving, and he hit the ring hard. Mike got out of the way. On the rebound, he's coming over. Mike Van Erich, with Gino pinned in the rope. Mike right back with a kick in the midsection. Taking advantage of the opportunities, Brock Lubick tries to help Gino out of the rope. Gino out now, but Mike's still in the driver's seat. American Heavyweight Championship belt on the line. A mob on hand here at the convention center. Gino hits hard after going over the shoulder, and look at this. And Mike Van Erich has seen that before. Mike looks like he's been studying films as well as working out. He knew that trade in Gino Hernandez and didn't fall for it. But Gino comes off that far rope and catches Mike with a foot. There's an elbow on the head. From the rope, there's a leapfrog. Gino turns, didn't know what to do, and he got drop kicked. Gino saying no, no, and Mike Von Erich upset with Gino's cowering tactics.
5 minutes.
We're 5 minutes deep. Gino very carefully backing around. The hands go high in this test of strength. We saw one of these in an arm wrestling bout earlier, which ended in disaster. This of a different nature here, a part of the bout. Mike Von Erich down to one knee. Gino forcing him down and back. Mike holding the shoulders up. Look at the streak in his leg. How about that? He reminds me of Kevin with that leg streak. Gino on the seat of his pants and in a position where his legs can't help him much, except for flipping over and going over the rope, which he just did. Gino in his good guy white tights moves around the ring to the cat calls from the ringside faces. Gino back in. We're into the second 5 minute segment of this American Heavyweight Championship bout. Here's a hammer lock by Mike Von Erich. County Convention Center, always the most exciting cards in Fort Worth.
No, no,
Gino reaches underneath, grabs that foot, kicked away. The crowd begins to cheer. I don't know if the fight is broken out in the crowd or what. No, it's Stella May, and she's been attacked. Stella May, standing out in the floor area outside the ring, has been attacked by, I guess this is this lady giant, this Dakota Roberts. Mike Von Erich has a sleeper on Gino Hernandez. Oh, no, Bronco just got a thumb in the eye. Here's the lady giant nailing Mike Von Erich from behind. Gino now slams Mike Von Erich over the knee with his shoulder. One, two, oh no.
Exactly 8 minutes in regaining the American heavyweight title of Gino Hernandez.
Well, Stella May French, and I have to admit I didn't see her. She was over there behind the officers, watching the bout from the floor out there. The crowd began to roar when this Nicola Roberts, Gino's lady giant, 6'2", 205 pounds, came up from behind her and attacked her. Stella May is laying on the ground and can't get up. Here comes Von Erich, chasing Gino out of the ring. The sad part about it is Mike Von Erich had Gino in the sleeper, but Bronco Lubitsch got a thumb in the eye when Gino was trying to fight out of it. And that allowed Nicola Roberts to come up from behind on Mike Von Erich and nail him. An unfortunate ending to the American Heavyweight title situation. Gino Hernandez has left the ring with the belt as the winner. We'll be back. I'll see if I can find out more, including the status of Stella May, who's down on the cement. Don't go away.
I'd be on hand to see the main event pitting Kerry Von Erich against Killer Khan. Now, with Khan in the corner, no doubt Akbar will be there. And as an added attraction, Kevin Von Erich will be in Kerry's corner during that bout. Akbar is upset about that, as you've heard tonight. The missing link will be facing Mike Gallagher. Skip Young will team with the Iceman against the Magnificent Irwin Brothers. Jake Roberts goes against Buck Rock and will zoom off. George Weindrop against Norvell Austin. Friday night, the Sporta Tournament Dallas. Be on hand for the exciting Friday night action. I'll see you there. Now let's go to the ring in our next bout. Okay, Ralph Foley's going to grab the mic and introduce this bout as we wait for the other team to arrive. 2 hours of championship sports continues now as we get into our closing bout of the evening. We'll show you as much of this as possible.
This event, one fall, 30-minute timing. First of all, representing General Akbar and Devastation Incorporated, the combined weight of over 500 pounds, Wild Bill Irwin and Scott Hog Irwin. And their opponent, with a combined weight over 490 pounds, Chief Jules Strongbow and Buck Rock and Roll Zumhoff. Your referee is Rick Hazard.
Rick Hazard will officiate this event. As Zumhoff and Chief Jules Strongbow must be very careful. Now, I know you're anxious to hear what has happened. Stella May has been hurt, and she has been taken out of the building into the hospital for examination. She had to be helped out. More bad news. It gets worse as we go. Mike Von Erich has had that shoulder injured. You'll recall Gino threw him so tremendously over that knee. Mike Von Erich's shoulder hurt, and his status for the sixth man is unknown. And keep in mind, the crowd that's here will be seeing that coming on, although we'll be out of time. And they are throwing all of their equipment at me as they leave the ring. The whip by the Irwin brothers. Rick Hazard wants Akbar out of the way. Zumhoff wants the music box. That music angers the Irwin brothers to no end and angers Akbar. Here's Strongbow around on one end, Zumhoff on the other. Well, excitement will be coming up at Will Rogers Coliseum Monday night. Here we go. Strongbow still in the Indian headdress. Wild Bill gets shot. Irwin hit part of the corner. Zip off in now on Scott Hall. It's a wild, wild beginning. As Zumhoff and the Indian are all over the Irwin brothers. Akbar doesn't know what's happened. Well, I hope you've enjoyed the excitement from the convention center tonight as the punishment continues for the Irwin. Hope you'll be on hand Monday night and Friday night, and of course, don't miss our telecast coming up next Saturday night. We'll have 2 more hours of the world's finest professional wrestling for you. Strongbow now, ready to get down to serious business. Irwin's after Zim off the floor. Hope you're on hand to see all this. Until next week, this is Mark Lawrence for our entire crew. Good night, everybody. We'll be right back.
Hello, wrestling fans, and welcome to this week's edition of Mid-South Wrestling Television Network. I'm your host, Boyd Pierce, and we have a lot of exciting action coming up. You'll see tag team match, the Pretty Young Things, Norvell Austin and Coco Ware versus the Midnight Express, Bobby Eaton and Dennis Condrey. Brickhouse Brown, who made such a sensational debut last week, he gets in the ring once again with Buddy Landell, who says that he was just a ringer that was brought in next week. We'll see about that. Also, the fantastic Tommy Rogers and Bobby Fulton will be in action to tell us about it. Joel Watts, who's really being articulate, he's coming along, he has the knowledge to back it up, and we're going to listen to Joel. Right now, earlier, we saw Ernie Ladd talking to Nature Boy Buddy Landell. Jim Ross was there, so let's listen to what they had to say.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, after the exciting turn of events that happened here last week of Mid-South Wrestling, Nature Boy Buddy Landell has requested to make this statement.
That's exactly what I'm trying to tell you. Mid-South Sports, like I said last week, is trying to throw Buddy Landell curveballs. This guy, Brickhouse Brown, I found out Grizzly Smith stuck him in there. He's a ringer. He's one of the toughest guys in the country. Shut up! What's Mid-South Sports trying to do to Buddy Landell? There ain't no way you're going to get me to leave, so what do I got to do? I got to go out and get the smartest man in professional wrestling, Ernie Ladd. Ernie Ladd. Listen, there's only one Brickhouse, and that's Hacksaw Butch Reed. This guy, Brickhouse Brown, nobody's ever beat me like that. Jim Ross, you know, look at me in my eyes and tell me that ain't nobody ever beat me like that. I beat Junkyard Dogs. We run.